Islamic perspective. Al-kharaj bil-dhaman. Al-ghunmu bil-ghurmi. Islamic legal maxim says. Al-ghunmu meaning gain must be associated with some types of risk. For example, for another example is investment. You are putting out money, you are putting in money as investment, you are rabul mal, sahibul mal or investor. Okay? 1 million crown to this entrepreneur. Entrepreneur will bear risk that all of their efforts in 1 year faces loss. You will bear risk. If loss happen, you will lose all of your cash. That is risk. Yeah, that kind of risk is crucial and obligatory in order for you to invest. Because it is the pillars of justice to both party. But in insurance, it's different. Different, okay? Because you are putting up money out of something that you are not sure. Yes, investment also not sure. But you can ensure that the business is viable and the entrepreneur is trustworthy and experienced, skillful, and so on and so forth. So that is not gambling. That is a calculated risk. Calculated risk is okay. All right.
Sometimes I'm sure you know that we get free insurance.
Free insurance. Okay. Free insurance is acceptable in Islam. Okay. Free insurance. But normally, free insurance will be given if you subscribe to a credit card.
Yeah.
Credit card is not permissible. If debit card, and because of the subscription of the debit card or charge card, you will get free insurance, then it's okay. But must be stick to the repayment terms, must full payment in 1 month.
So many bank accounts now, they give you free life insurance. So
okay. Okay, if the account is not an Islamic account, the account itself is non-halal. I know you in check there is no Islamic bank. Okay, so there is a necessity for you. You cannot just simply place your cash under your pillow. Difficult, dangerous, you know. So yes, in check in Ireland there is no Islamic bank. So the scholars agree that you are in great need, so you can place.
In English, there is Islamic bank.
Or in England, you cannot.
So if I use any other bank, it's wrong.
No. You cannot use conventional account. You have to put your money in the Islamic Bank of Britain or Lloyds Bank. They have Islamic account. Yes, that's permissible. Or HSBC Amana, they have Amana branches. That's permissible.
Just depositing money there so that I can go to an ATM and take money out.
Yeah.
I'm not allowed to do this.
Yeah, you are allowed to do that.
I'm in any.
If the Islamic bank.
Non-Islamic bank,
you cannot. Because what? I have told you just now, the bank will utilize your money to give. So you are supporting the bank. So Allah SWT said, وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. So you cannot support the bank in any way. Alright?
What if it's a way that you can't change?
You can change?
Yeah,
mean?
What if, like...
You can change. You can. Except if you are here.
But what if I have a company? For example, I have a shop, somebody comes to pay it to me with Visa, and I'm paying Visa 2%. Is this, if you understand this, if I can't help this situation?
Okay, that's difficult. That's true, that's necessity. Okay, that's necessity. If the you are a seller, and then the party, the buyer is purchasing from you, and then they are paying with the Visa card, that is acceptable from the Islamic perspective because that is their responsibility, not yours. It's beyond your responsibility. But the problem here is that you are paying that 1 or 2% to the Visa. But that is still permissible, yes. Because you are paying because of the valid reason, services of the card, valid reason. Okay, just like you are purchasing, okay, there is a restaurant, for example, there is a supermarket, Tesco. The Tesco is selling pork, ham, bacon, liquor, and so on and so forth. Can you purchase something there? Do you understand the question? Do you understand the questions? Okay, the shop is selling non-halal items. And then you are going to the store and purchasing the halal item. Is it permissible? Is it supporting them? No. No. If it is regarded as supporting, you cannot purchase anything in this world. You cannot purchase this computer because Dell is non-Muslim, so they have this with Israel with okay. You cannot purchase anything.
Maybe I don't know if it's your area, but what working for these places?
Working in the bank.
Working in Tesco. Working in the bank.
Working in the Tesco is still permissible as a cleaner, as a cashier, but you cannot touch the liquor. You cannot arrange the liquor to make it more beautiful, you know. So,
as a cashier, you have to put the liquor.
That's the problem. So we if that happen, your income will be shubhah, little bit shubhah, mix. So in order to cleanse, so you have to cleanse your income with giving out sadaqah, maybe 100 crowns to the masjid.
Working in the bank.
Working in the bank, the scholars discuss. So their conclusion is that you cannot work as direct to the riba promotion. So meaning, for example, you are a sales executive in marketing. Hey, come here, take this loan. You cannot do that because the Prophet in the hadith said, "La'ana Rasulullah SAW akilah riba wa mukilahu wa shahidahu wa katibahu." Hadis itu sahih. Meaning, our Prophet SAW la'ana condemns all parties involved in riba, the writer, the witness, the giver, the receiver, all of them.
So it's difficult to be a salesman now.
Salesman? Yeah, you can sell anything. How?
In many places in like sofa shops or PC World or Curry to be a
yes. You want to work there?
No, if people do work there.
No problem.
They usually have to advertise a warranty.
Well, even interest, you don't have to pay interest.
Oh, you have to advertise the warranty.
But when someone comes and says, "I want to buy this," then you say.
But normally EPC World, the warranty will come with the price. So the warranty is just like pre, you know, for the 1 month. 1 month. So you just tell the customer for 1 month. Do not promote the customer to take to extend the warranty. Because, and it is beyond your job scope. Your job scope is to promote the computer, that's all. And then the price of the computer comes with the free 1 month warranty. It's okay, still okay. Alright? Okay? Yeah. This one is difficult. Not difficult because of I have the knowledge, I know, but it's difficult because I don't think we have sufficient time in order for me to explain how the Islamic banks works. But in short, it is halal. And there are scholars responsible in order to ensure all of the applications and the processes are halal. Just believe them. Put faith. Insurance for debit card? Insurance. Insurance is still same decree. Yeah. Okay. Alright, I think two main questions. Actually, I have a lot more. We have gharar and jahala. Okay, do you have... Before question. Okay, we are in UK, we have National Rail Card, you know? Yeah. Do you have rail card here?
Yes.
Yeah, you have to pay And then you will get discount. Is that halal? Okay, I still not discuss that. Alright? Alright? So do you have discount card? Is that halal? I still not discuss that. Okay, so there are many things that you have to learn. Okay, now questions, yeah. استفتي قلبك. Do not place the burden on me. استفتي قلبك. Okay. All right.
What about the credit card issued by HSBC Amanah?
Halal. Because it's called credit card, but actually it's not credit card. It's sale credit card. How do they do it? Long discussion. And technical discussion, but put your faith on the Sharia scholars. All of these banks, if they want to offer Islamic products, there are scholars certified the product. So it's difficult to discuss right now. Okay. All right. Now we want to move a little bit on gharar. Gharar is also associated to excessive speculation or gambling. How many minutes do we have? Already finished? Okay, I take another 10 minutes, inshallah. 10 minutes. All right, gharar and jahalah. Jahalah is ignorance and unclear about the item or the product or the price. Okay, for example, here, gharar areas. Due to delivery time of the product. For example, you are purchasing carpet, you are purchasing rugs, you are purchasing computer from internet, but you have no idea when the product will be delivered. And you also don't have any idea if the product is not being delivered in within 1 month, who do you want to call? That kind of transaction is haram because gharar. eBay, you know. eBay, you know how to deal with the problem, because you can email the seller, and then if the seller keep quiet, you can condemn, you can send problem, you can send a dispute, or you can send comment to the eBay, so eBay will refund you. So just like my friends in UK, he purchased television, and the television arrived not suit the specification. Okay, and then the seller don't want to take anything. Okay, so what happened is that he also write to the eBay. So eBay UK refund. eBay UK refund, not the seller. eBay UK. And eBay International also keep track this problem. And eBay International also refund. So my friend said, I already get the refund from eBay UK. No problem, you take it. So two price. So, and then he purchased a better television with that large money. Rezeki lah, rezeki. So eBay is okay. Okay, and then also involved in investment. There are a lot of investment via internet today, right? You have forex trading, for example. All of them, most of them are haram because of riba, because they are fixing your return, and also some of them are haram because there are no details of the company and the business provided in the internet. So if something happens, you will call somebody, nobody will answer, you know. So that will be a great problem. So most of the people love to have quick rich, quick cash and so on and so forth. But please beware on the gharar. Okay? And then due to the price. Price meaning, for example, a purchase. You want to purchase something, but the price, the seller say the price will be like this. If you are paying within 2 months, the price will be 200. If you want to pay on installment in for 4 months, the price will be